This is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. I have another exciting episode for you, and today is my gardening EOS. You might be thinking, John, what the heck does EOS stand for? Well, it's very simple. It stands for end of season. So at the end of the season here, what you need to do is you need to start pulling out your summer stuff. And as you saw in our previous video, I started pulling out the tomatoes. The next thing to come up actually are the lemon cucumbers here. You can see some of these monsters here. That guy has a little writer there, so we're going to go ahead and pick that guy off. But this is a nice lemon cucumber here, nice and large. So what happens is the lemon cucumbers and tomatoes and peppers are summer crops. And, you know, they don't like when it gets too cold. It'll literally freeze unless you live in the tropics where it never freezes, which is a place I'd like to live. Nonetheless, when it freezes, what happens to these plants is that they just don't make it. They cease to exist, kind of like if you frosted and got too cold. So what'll happen is the plants will not make it, and the fruits will also be damaged. So it's very prudent to actually guesstimate when it's going to frost, and actually before it does do the frost thing, to harvest everything. Of course, you always want to try to, you know, get it before the frost and not after the frost. Lately, we've actually have had some reports in this area of 31 degree nights, so that's below frosting, but nothing here has frosted yet. But I know it's definitely coming soon, because usually past years, maybe the beginning of December, the end of November, that's when the frost hits. So, you know, I'm harvesting about 2 weeks early. I might have another 2 weeks on these guys, but you know what? They've produced a lot for me this summer season, so I'm going to go ahead and harvest the rest and, you know, basically put them inside so that I could store these guys inside, whether it's in the fridge or just a cool place. And then I'll be able to enjoy these for definitely weeks to come. If I did leave these out and it did freeze, then these guys would actually turn to jello. Well, not exactly. They'd be a blob, and then you wouldn't be able to save them because they'd be already toast. So some plants are more sensitive to the frost than others. As I mentioned, the tomatoes are more sensitive, and then the cucumbers. And you can see, I mean, this is just the time of the end of the season for the cucumbers. The leaves are kind of getting, you know, yellowed out, and we're getting some white powdery mildew, and they're not looking so healthy anyway. So yet another reason to pull them. Next, what we're gonna do is actually I'm gonna harvest all these cucumbers that are still hanging, and I'm gonna pull down the vines, and then we'll be back at you in a little bit to share some of the process with you. So as you guys can see, I'm actually almost done. I got, I think, pretty much 3/4 of the trellis emptied, and this is my leaning trellis of Pisa, or leaning trellis of my front yard. Let's see here. So what I want to talk to you guys about now are harvesting. And you can see I got some gloves on. That's because these cucumbers got these little spikes on them. Now, they're not going to hurt you, but they're a minor inconvenience and they may cause itching. So I got some gloves on here. Always protect your hands. They're one of the most important tools you got. In any case, you can see here I'm harvesting. And when I'm harvesting, you know, I'm going to definitely see small little guys like these. Now, if it's not a mouthful, it's probably not worth keeping. Number one, these immature ones, while you can't eat them, you know, they're not going to store long, and they're hardly any food. So I'm composting some of these small guys. I'm saving the ones that are more mature because they're going to last. Another question you guys might be thinking is, hey, John, what do you harvest the lemon cucumbers in? You know, do you have, you know, wooden crates or what? Well, let me go ahead and show you guys what I'm using here. What I'm using here are these standard, actually, boxes, actually, from your local warehouse club store. So these were actually picked up at Costco last night, actually. These are for Campari tomatoes. And I like these because what this allows you to do, this box allows you to do, it allows you basically to, you know, have a single layer. And you could actually kind of see all the fruits at once and see which ones are ripening, which ones need to be used. And you could check them to see which ones are soft or not. If you get a standard box and pile them all in there, you know, the ones on the bottom might rot before you see them because you're not looking at them. So I like to lay everything out in single file lines so I can determine what I need to use now. And if they're going bad, I need to get rid of them because rot begots rot. And they have all different kinds of these boxes. That's a Campari, and actually here's one, the Monterey mushroom. And a nice thing about Costco, I think they pretty much told their suppliers, hey, you guys need to make your, you know, boxes exactly this size. And all these guys are really cool. They stack up. So they got these little tabs in here and they stack up. So all your harvest could easily store neatly. And at your warehouse club store, these guys are free. So, you know, as long as they're empty, they're free. And, you know, I like to use these as much as I can, and then when they're kind of getting messed up, then I'll just go ahead and recycle them and get more. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to finish up harvesting these guys, and I'll come back at you and show you my incredible yield today of the lemon cucumbers. As you guys can see, I got four nice size boxes, and these guys weigh at least, man, 25 pounds each. So I harvested over 100 pounds of my favorite lemon cucumbers. Now you might be thinking, John, what the heck are you gonna do with all those cucumbers? Because they're gonna start expiring really fast. That means going bad. And what I like to do with these guys is actually juice them right up. So I like drinking vegetable juices instead of water to keep myself hydrated. The fresh juices are rich in nutrients, plus they also quench my thirst really well. Another thing I like to do with the lemon cucumbers is, of course, cut them up on salads. And last year, actually, I made lacto-fermented lemon cucumber juice. So check my past videos for that. That stuff is the bomb. So I'm probably gonna make some more this year. Nonetheless, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode learning about when to harvest your summer crops at the EOS, that's the end of season. Next, I'm actually off to harvest some peppers before the sun goes down. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. And once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing.